I've done some pretty crazy things in my life, but this one definitely ranks up there as one of the craziest. A fencing lesson with Olympic silver medalist, Tim Morehouse. Hey everyone, I'm here at the Manhattan Fencing Center with Tim Morehouse, who is a three-time All-American and Olympic silver medalist in fencing. So we're going to talk today all about fencing and the sort of crazy stuff that goes along with it. So thanks so much for being with us today.
Yeah, it's really great to be here.
How are you doing?
I'm great. I'm excited to chat a little about the great sport of fencing with you.
Well, I know very little about fencing. I think I mentioned something before we started. So tell us like what the basics are about fencing.
Well, most people tend to know our sport from the movies like Pirates of the Caribbean, and they think it's a lot of like flailing around.
Swashbuckling. But,
the sport of fencing, it's a precision sport. You have to be very small in what you do and very precise in everything you're doing. So our sport, it comes from like kings and nobility. They used to duel for honor. And now it's electronic, it's very safe. And we have a lot of the history and a lot of the honor still with us today. And it's a really fantastic sport.
And how did you personally sort of get involved initially in fencing?
You know, I think it was pretty typical. I did not even know what the sport was. And at my middle school, you could get out of PE if you joined fencing. So I was like, I don't really know what this is, but let me go check this out. I went, I joined, I just had a lot of fun like hitting people with metal objects and not getting in trouble. And then I like slowly fell in love with it.
When people approach you about fencing, like what do you think some of the biggest misconceptions are?
You know, it's kind of funny. There's sort of like a typical response when someone finds out you're a fencer. Everyone seems to know this like pose.
Right.
They tend to do that to you. They're like, oh, fencer, and do one of these. I think there's not a lot of information about the actual sport. A lot of the stuff that you see is sort of this, you know, glamorized stuff in the movies, which is really cool, and a lot of people start the sport because of Zorro and because of Pirates of the Caribbean. And the sport itself is a lot of fun as well, and I think people are like, a little about like, what is this thing? And I think once you try it, it's like people just fall in love with it.
And do you think that like one of the things people don't understand is actually how athletic it is?
Yeah, I think that's probably one of the misperceptions, that we're not athletes, or you know, you have to be extremely athletic and extremely smart. So people call it a combination of boxing and chess. We spend hours on footwork, being able to move, and then you also have to really be able to think and change your strategy and know your opponent. So it's a really great sport that challenges you both mentally and physically.
Did you ever in your life dream that this was going to be what the outcome was going to be of your sort of getting out of PE?
No, not at all. You know, I used to actually skate around in my house in socks watching like the Winter Olympics and envisioning being an Olympian, but they just seemed so like immortal to me when I was a kid.
And what was it like going to the Olympics? I can't even imagine, you know, I love the Olympics. I can't live without watching them, so I dream about it. But what was that like?
I typically say it's like the movie or the books, Chronicles of Narnia, because you pretty much enter this very, very surreal world for 3 weeks of your life. It's just like this very surreal experience. You feel like you live a whole lifetime in those 3 weeks.
Now, I also read that you taught fencing to the president.
Yes.
How did that come about?
You know, since Beijing, I've really had this sort of mission to promote fencing. And I was trying to get myself into every place possible to show people our sport. And it just so happened, you know, we were trying to get the Chicago Olympics for 2016, which ended up not happening. But they had an event at the White House. And the great thing about fencing is you can kind of do it almost anywhere.
Right.
So we went and they had all these other Olympic sports, but, you know, it was like gymnastics, but Obama's not gonna get on like a high beam. There was like wrestling. I don't think they let him throw Obama.
No, I don't think so.
So he came over to fencing and he spent like 15 minutes with us. We got to show him some moves. He had a lot of questions about it. And he had the same thing. He knew like the pose like right away. So it was cool. I think he'd be a pretty good fencer. I think Michelle Obama might be better though.
Okay. Well, he is an athlete and so is she. And I am, was at some point, maybe considered myself an athlete, I don't know. But I'm sure you're gonna have a much harder time teaching me the basics of fencing than you did the president. So let's see what we can do and how big a fool I can make of myself today.
I think you'll do all right. You're in good hands.
You're very kind, that I believe. So all right, let's get to it.
Awesome.
All right.
All right, so first things first, we're gonna shake hands with our bare hands. Notice my left. So they used to start the duel with their gloves.
Right.
So we kind of keep that tradition where if someone were to shake your hand with a glove in fencing, they're basically insulting.
Oh, okay.
And then we also salute each other. So you're gonna start in first position of dancing, and you're gonna take your front foot, and you're gonna step out with it about a foot. And then you're gonna bend your knees, and you're gonna bring this hand up like this. And this is what we call en garde position.
Okay.
Now in fencing, you're just moving linearly. So we have advancing and retreating. So for the advance, you're gonna take your front foot, moves forward, and then your back foot follows. That's an advance.
Okay.
Retreat, your back foot goes first, and then your front foot. So advance, and then retreat. Now to hit someone in fencing, we hit them with what we call the lunge. Basically, you know how you do a lunge at a gym where you step out? That's basically the same thing. So just like you would lunge at the gym, extend your arm and then step out with your front leg. Perfect. And then recover back. Basically, we want to try to reach your opponent. So there's a little spring to your push. Perfect.
Okay.
Because you want to be able to get somewhere. So I'm going to put this mask on. You can hit me anywhere, anywhere that's open.
Okay.
Cool. Parry. Good. And hit. Boom. Are you ready to hook up?
I'm ready to hook
get
up.
Get this electronic
yes,
fencing going?
Yes, I am.
Awesome. All right, ready. Watch this. If we both hit at the same time, go. You'll see the two lights are on.
And what about a tie?
No ties.
Ever?
Ever.
Not possible.
Someone's winning.
Oh, and mine doesn't work.
If you hit yourself, it won't go on either.
Because well, that's more likely than anything is that I'm going to be hitting myself, so.
Spencer, they're doing this, which you can do in Saber. Look, good look. Now, normally as a referee, so he would say to both of us, on guard, in which case we would get boom in our ready position.
What do I do with this hand?
You just leave it dangling.
Okay.
Good parry. Come on, you can do it. You can do it. I believe in you. Hit me. Try somewhere else. Go. I think your shoelace is untied.
What?
Oh, that's this is the oldest trick in the book you fell
that's
for.
Not, I'm like, what?
That's not honor, though.
Yeah, that's not honor.
I didn't fence with honor. It's the one sport you can see that. All right, here we go. Sudden death. Fence. You get me? I'll give you the 10 times again. I think I was 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Uh-oh. Oh. Woo. And then the fencing, the celebration, you can't yell in people's face, so generally you turn around and you go like, woo, like the other way.
Well, thank you for spending the afternoon with us. What a really unexpected pleasure, and it's been so much fun. You're a great teacher.
Well, thank you so much, and you are a great student as well.
Oh, well.
I think if you came for a few months, you'd really hold your own.
Well,
we have to work
you.
On your fainting, though.
Well, thank you, and Manhattan Fencing Center, and you are a great ambassador to the sport, so thanks so much for a
thanks
really
so
wonderful,
much.
Unexpected afternoon.
We can salute everyone.
Yes.